Hello and welcome to Thought on Thursday. And today's topic is getting a reply. Getting a reply. Are any of you waiting for a reply from someone? Maybe some official thing, or maybe from a friend, or maybe finding out whether you're meeting up with someone. Receiving a reply. Well, this is actually a follow-up to a previous Thought on Thursday when I posed the question, who would you love to meet? Who would you love to spend time with and contact and talk to? Obviously, my point there was, even though we might like to contact some famous people or people from the past or whatever, we can contact God anytime. And this follow-up is about getting a reply, because when I talked about who would you like to make contact with, I talked about the adventure cyclist Mark Beaumont. I was reading his book Around the World in 80 Days, and I said I'd love to meet him and love to chat to him. And after I'd recorded the thought on Thursday, because I'm Mark Beaumont's friend on Facebook, I sent him a messenger with the link to the thought on Thursday. I actually sent it to him on the 13th of May. I didn't hear anything back. But at the end of August, so just last week, I got a reply from him. Here's the photo now of the string of messages. A very short reply, didn't really say much, and not even sure he did watch Thought on Thursday, or maybe even his PA sent a reply. But actually, I'm not going to think about those things. I got a reply from Mark Beaumont. I was really excited. The reason I took that photo was to send it to my husband to say, look, Mark Beaumont replied to me. Well, let's bring it back to my Christian faith and to God. And the real question I want to ask you is, do you think God speaks today? I talked a lot about prayer. And when you pray and speak to God, do you expect him to reply to you? Do you think God speaks today? Well, I believe God does speak today. He is the living God. He's active in our lives and in the world. And he wants to speak to us, his children who he loves. And I think there are three key ways in which he speaks to us: through his word, the Bible, directly, and through other people. But the main way in which God replied for all time is in sending Jesus. And in John's Gospel at the beginning, it says the word became flesh. God's message of love to us became real in Jesus. But God is living and he does speak to us today. I wonder if you're waiting for a reply from him. Why not ask him again, but listen really attentively to God's reply. I'm Amanda Featherstone. I'm the vicar of St Mary's Church, Withall, and this has been my Thought on Thursday. There won't be a Thought on Thursday for a couple of weeks now, but if you do want to link into my Facebook page, there might be a few photos or a couple of videos from a cycling adventure I'm going on in Scotland. But stay safe and take care.